Yeah, really the big story out here is the wind. It has just been unrelenting, picking up that sand and just blowing it around. It actually feels like rocks hitting your skin. The wind combined with the high tide today, these two forces of nature caused some flooding here in Hampton Beach.
The marshy areas of Hampton Beach are prone to flooding, but not like this.
Yeah, we dragged everything out of the front yard. And
Randy Jamison lives on Island Path Road. For him, he hasn't seen flooding like this in years. He's worried about his neighbors as Sandy begins to battle.
She's having a fit right now. It's okay. You know, that's New Hampshire for you, right? Or that's storms for you, I tell you.
Just down the road from Jamison, people gathered on Hampton Beach watching the waves.
Yeah, the waves are unbelievable.
The waves were large, angry, and packed a punch. Families with kids left sensing the danger.
Winds are strong.
Gail Robbins and her family traveled from Wilmington, Mass to see Sandy. For Gail, it's like nothing she's ever seen.
Never in my life. And I'm 60 years old. Never. Nope, never in my life in New England.
Waves continued to pound the seawall, swallowing the beach. Water splashed over onto Route 1A. Drivers slowed to take pictures, causing traffic to back up. By afternoon, though, the high tide receded, and so did some of the flooding waters. However, as the storm continues to churn, these people are bracing for more.
Yeah, it's getting worse, you know.
And as you heard AJ say, this is low tide right now. So as the night goes on and the rain progresses and the wind progresses, when that high tide comes in just after midnight, we could see some more damage. Of course, people out here are hoping that's not the case. For now, though, we are live here on Hampton Beach in Expedito, WMUR News 9.